Well, Woman in Gold is at its core is about justice. It's about one woman's fight for justice, and that it's never too late to get that justice. And Maria Altman is a woman who's an octogenarian and who has lived in America for 5 decades and was the victim of art theft by Nazis. She and her family were looted by the Nazis in the 30s and lost everything. They lost their home, they lost their family, they lost their friends. And she immigrated to America to have a life and to live and to escape this war. And she wants what is rightfully hers. And that is to get this painting back, this painting that it was taken from her walls. It's not about the painting, though. That's what's sort of, you know, it's easy to sort of think of it like an Indiana Jones movie, and these two are after this treasure. But it actually, at the end of the day, has very little to do with the painting, and everything to do with justice, closure, and a sense of peace, and having some peace in her life. And I think that this woman, Maria Altman, is incredibly afraid to die without having at least closed this chapter and done everything she can to restore what was rightfully hers and her family's and their memories. And it's about honoring them and the world that they created before the Nazis came in and disassembled everything. So I play a character named Randy Schoenberg, who is a young lawyer, and he has been chosen by Maria Altman to handle this case, this art restitution case, which involves one of the most priceless works of art in the world's history. That is Adele, that is The Woman in Gold. The painting has several titles, but it is a magnificent Gustav Klimt painting. And this particular painting was stolen off the walls of Maria Altman's home when she was a little girl by the Nazis. And for 5 decades, it had hung in the Belvedere Gallery in Austria. And these two people, Randy and Maria, decide to go after it and try to bring it home. Well, the historical significance was really amazing. I mean, you know, to think that this actually happened, that these two unlikely heroes managed to take this thing all the way through local courts to Supreme Courts to right in front of Austria's arbitration committee is remarkable. And I love that. I love a good story like that. I love a good story where we get to follow two underdogs in this way and see how they relate to one another, but more importantly, really see them fight for something that we all know is just and right. Yeah, I met with Randy Schoenberg. I was careful not to be doing an impression of Randy Schoenberg because we just physically speaking, we look different, we sound different. There's no, you know. But I really studied up on his on these three gigantic hurdles that he crossed in order to make this dream become a reality. One was the local courts, the second was the Supreme Court, and the third was the arbitration hearing in Vienna. And I also just liked hearing about his relationship with Maria. You know, I liked hearing about the little nuances and little things that they did and how they interacted with one another and that unlikely love story that they had. So it was really helpful for that. This movie is not a romantic comedy, but there is a great deal of comedic tension between both Randy and Maria, and that was something that I felt was important. You know, in reading the script, I enjoyed the friction that these two have, and I also enjoyed the fact that there's a love story there, that this is a love story between a young man and an older woman. And while it may not be romantic in nature, it is definitely a love story, though. These two are the Bickersons at times, and these two are at each other's throats and at odds. And you see by the third act or by the end of this film that these two are desperately in love with each other as well. And I love that. There's no shortage in Hollywood of stories about the war and about the Holocaust and the tragedies that happened therein. But I do like that this sheds a light on the idea of reconnecting with it. I do like the idea that we're sort of spotlighting the fact that people don't connect to their own heritage the way they used to. You know, we live in this instant world of, you know, Twitter and computers and all kinds of distracting sort of elements that, you know, it's easy to forget the generations gone by, what they sacrificed and what they gave to so we could all have this, you know. And this definitely explores some of that territory. You know, I think for my character, for Randy, this was a humongous eye-opener. I mean, he could, you know, there's a scene in the movie where he can barely stand up. He's so overcome with emotion when it hits him, how profound the impact was that the Holocaust had on his family and the lives that it took. You know, it directly took his great-grandparents, and that was something that really hit home for him. Certainly there's a history lesson there, and you know, when you can wrap up a history lesson in an entertaining package like this and deliver it in a way that is so moving and powerful, I think that says a lot. That's hard to do these days, but I also think that they'll take away the I think some of the notions that it's never too late to seek closure, and it's never too late to find justice in this world, and you know, if you believe in something, you have to fight for it, and it doesn't matter if you're 85 years old or if you're 28 years old.
There's kind of like a hidden sort of little romantic comedy underneath this story, about justice, and it's that's the thing that's kind of really tickled me in a weird way, because it was not something I expected going into it. I expected a very sort of hardened kind of dramatic arc and storyline, and it was much, much more than that. It was really dynamic and really rich, and I think any great dramatic pieces have great comedic elements, and great comedic films have wonderful dramatic elements as well, and this is a nice mix of those. Gosh, we were like fire in a dry house. It was pretty evident from the get-go, and that's always something that I realize and never take for granted, because it's chemistry. You can't really manufacture it. You have it or you don't. And even the greatest actors can't really manufacture it. You just have to use what you're given. And we were really lucky. We have a bit of a mutual admiration there that works really well for us. I think people are going to be really surprised by it, actually. I think people are going to really respond to it, because it is, we do learn a great deal while watching the film, and we're taken on this incredibly emotional journey, but we're also treated to a lot of entertainment along the way. I think there are moments that really make you laugh in the film, and there are moments that obviously will make you cry. And I think the resilience and relentlessness of this character, of Maria Altman's character, is something that a lot of people aspire to, and a lot of people are. And I think that, you know, film can sometimes hold a mirror up for us, and that's obviously a beautiful thing. And I think it'll be really inspiring.